अंत में आए। ये दो स्तंभ हैं जिसके आधार पे देश आगे बढ़ता है, इकोनॉमिक प्रॉस्पेरिटी इकोनॉमिक प्रॉस्पेरिटी एंड सोशल जस्टिस आर द टू पिलर्स ऑफ द बेसिस ऑफ व्हिच अ नेशन मूव्स फॉरवर्ड। In the last 5 years, we have seen a decline of economic prosperity. And we have seen the fracturing of social justice. पिछले 5 सालों में आर्थिक प्रगति को बहुत ठोस पहुंची है, उसमें कटौती आई और जो सामाजिक न्याय है उसको वो सामाजिक अन्याय की ओर जा रहा है। पिछले 5 साल के कार्यकाल में आपको मालूम है कि नरेंद्र मोदी की सरकार ने आने से पहले और आने के बाद कितने वायदे किए और जो उन्होंने कदम उठाए उसकी वजह से आज की जो हमारी आर्थिक स्थिति है उसमें इतनी कटौती आ चुकी है कि बैंकों के एनपीए 10,000 करोड़ से ज्यादा, एमएसएमई सेक्टर बर्बाद हो गया नोटबंदी की वजह से, क्रेडिट मिलता नहीं है नोटबंदी की वजह से, आम आदमी की बिजनेसेस बर्बाद हो गई, बेरोजगारी का स्तर इस दर पे पहुंच चुका है कि लाखों करोड़ों रोज करोड़ों लोग बेरोजगार हैं और समाज की जो दीवारें हैं उसमें दरार आ गई। इन द लास्ट फ्यू इयर्स बिकॉज ऑफ द डिसीजंस ऑफ मोदीज गवर्नमेंट द इकोनॉमिक सिचुएशन इज इम्पेयर्ड एंड सोशल जस्टिस has moved towards social injustice. The lynching of Dalits, the destruction of the MSME sector, the suicides of over 36,000 farmers during the last 5 years have resulted in agricultural distress, rural distress, and the lack of economic prosperity has resulted in mass loss of jobs. In fact, around 11 million jobs have been lost during the last 5 years. You remember Modi ji prior to 2014 talked about Achhe Din. Now Modi ji doesn't talk about it anymore because he knows that he never fulfilled his promise. The 15 lakhs that he used to send to you people in your bank accounts never came. 15 लाख का वादा था वो भी झूठा था, जो अच्छे दिन लाने का वादा था वो भी झूठा निकला। तो इसलिए कांग्रेस पार्टी ने सोचा कि इसीलिए इस मैनिफेस्टो का टाइटल है कांग्रेस विल डिलीवर, हम जो कहते हैं करके दिखाते हैं। इसमें एक बदलाव की सोच, the manifesto really talks about a tectonic change to take the country forward, and I will just give you a few instances of that. Let's talk about farms. As far as farmers are concerned, our Nyay scheme will give to the 20% poorest families in this country 72,000 rupees a year into their bank accounts. Now that's a huge step. If you remember that under the scheme of the NDA, the farmers, because of the distress within the farmers, were only to get 6,000 rupees, 2,000 rupees to be paid every quarter. And as you know, that the 6,000 rupees will not even cover the input cost of farmers. Nyay ke elan ke antargat har kisan ko 75,000 rupaiya salana milega. हर गरीब तबके के लोगों को, जो 20% सबसे गरीब तबके हैं, उन परिवारों को, तो लगभग 25 करोड़ लोगों को, 5 करोड़ परिवारों को वो राहत मिली 72,000 रुपए की। मोदी जी ने ऐलान किया अभी कुछ एक दो महीने पहले कि हम 6,000 रुपया किसानों को देंगे और 2,000 रुपया हर 4 महीने के बाद आने, ताकि 6,000 रुपया मिले। 6,000 रुपये में तो उनकी जो इनपुट कॉस्ट है वो ही नहीं पूरी होगी। और मोदी जी ने जो स्वामीनाथन कमीशन के प्रावधान थे उनको भी लागू नहीं किया और झूठ बोला कि हमने लागू कर दिया। वी गोइंग टू रेकमेंड एंड वी गोइंग टू इम्प्लीमेंट द स्वामीनाथन कमीशन की कॉस्ट प्लस 50%। We are going to have a separate budget for agriculture. Like you have a separate budget for railways, you used to have it at one time, you can have a separate budget for agriculture. So that we actually target the problems within the farming sector. Then, the other very, very important announcement in this manifesto is about jobs. The Congress manifesto says that there are 4 lakh jobs that are vacant in the central government in the area of education and health. 4 lakh rozgar vacancies jo hain shiksha ke sambandh mein aur swasthya ke sambandh mein kendra sarkar ne wo aaj tak vacancies puri bhari nahi kari. हम वादा करते हैं कि एक साल में, और हमने वेरी बेस्टों में लिखा है कि जल्द से जल्द एक साल में ये 4 लाख वैकेंसीज उपलब्ध, the 4 lakh vacancies will be filled up during the course of 2019-20, and that's set out in our manifesto. But 20 लाख की वैकेंसीज राज्य सरकारों में शिक्षा और स्वास्थ्य के संबंध में, हमने कहा कि हम राज्य सरकारों को कहेंगे कि ये भी 20 लाख वैकेंसीज को जल्दी से जल्दी फिलअप करें। देर आर 20 लाख वैकेंसीज विच आर विद इन द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स इन द एजुकेशन एंड हेल्थ सेक्टर विच विल परसुएड द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स टू फिल अप आल्सो एज सून एज पॉसिबल। देन द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड सिग्निफिकेंट चेंज इज इन द दैट वी हैव डिवाइडेड द एमएसएमई सेक्टर इन टू 3 पार्ट्स। देर इज द माइक्रो सेक्टर, वो जो फैक्ट्रियां हैं, वो जो कामकाज के लोग हैं जिन्होंने 10 लोगों से कम को लोगों को रोजगार दे रहे हैं, वो हम उसको बोलते हैं माइक्रो सेक्टर। और जो स्मॉल स्केल सेक्टर है जिन्होंने 100 लोगों से कम को रोजगार दे रहे हैं कामकाज में, और फिर मीडियम सेक्टर है। तो हमने कहा है कि जो माइक्रो एंड स्मॉल स्केल सेक्टर है, मतलब कि जिन फैक्ट्रियों में, जिन बिजनेस संस्थाओं में 100 से कम या 10 से कम लोग काम करते हैं, उनको हम पूरी छूट देंगे 3 साल के लिए। इन अदर वर्ड्स, ऑल दोज एस्टैब्लिशमेंट्स विच एम्प्लॉय लेस देन 10 पीपल विच आर माइक्रो एस्टैब्लिशमेंट्स एंड लेस देन 100 पीपल विच आर स्मॉल स्केल एस्टैब्लिशमेंट्स, इन दोज एस्टैब्लिशमेंट्स वी गिव अ 3-year holiday of all approvals. And once we give a 3-year holiday of all approvals, it will mean that other than having to pay the tax, they don't have to get any other approvals. The result of that will be that there will be enormous economic activity at the bottom of the pyramid, which will lead to increase in jobs, which will lead to economic prosperity at that level. This is a huge step that we have taken and promised in our manifesto. Then we are in certain areas where jobs where labor is required, for example in the textile sector, in the leather sector, in tourism, where all kinds of jobs are available, we are going to give tax relief to all those people who actually, in these sectors, who employ more people. So that we give a boost to employment. The tourism sector, the leather sector, the textile sector, which is more and more rozgar, वहाँ अगर लोग ज्यादा रोजगार देंगे तो उनको टैक्स की दर पे उनको कुछ राहत मिलेगी ताकि ज्यादा से ज्यादा लोग ये वो बेरोजगारी खत्म हो. तो ये कुछ प्रावधान हमने आपके सामने रखे हैं. साथ साथ में हमने और भी कई चीजें रोजगार के संदर्भ में कहा है कि हम प्रयास करेंगे कि 10 लाख सेवा मित्र हम ग्राम पंचायत और अर्बन बॉडीज में नियुक्त करें. 10 लाख सेवा मित्र मतलब 10 लाख जॉब्स और ये पंचायत द्वारा हम किए जाएंगे करे जाएंगे. और हम ये भी एक एंटरप्राइज सपोर्ट एजेंसी जो स्टार्टअप्स वगैरह के लिए जो जो की सहायता करे वो भी हम लागू करेंगे. I can say that we are going to create about 10 lakh new seva mitra positions in every gram panchayat and urban local body. And as I said, we reward those businessmen who actually create jobs. Then the other enormously revolutionary scheme that we will amend the company's rules. Under the Companies Act, there are company's rules. We'll amend those company's rules and create an apprenticeship program where a company will be trained people in some kind of skill so that they can actually get employment later, and that be a 6-month program so that that has become statutory, because we will allow that to happen by amending the company rules. That and those people who are trained by those establishments will get a job in those establishments whenever a vacancy occurs. So these are steps that we have taken in the context of the distress in the farm sector and the enormous hunger for jobs, because our youth is unemployed, and we've done surveys throughout the country which suggest that the two major issues that are impacting the lives of people are farmers in the rural sector and jobs amongst youth. Those are the crying needs of our time. And remember, this government in the last 5 years has done nothing about it. Absolutely nothing about it. That is why farmers from Tamil Nadu actually go to Delhi and this government's representatives don't even meet them. Farmers walk hundreds of kilometers in Maharashtra to Mumbai and the government makes promises to them which they do not honor. And so we cannot continue with this. The model cannot be that the rich becomes the rich. Those who are rich become richer and the poor become poorer. In fact, in the last 5 years, I must tell you this, that 53% of the assets of this country are owned by 1% of the population. 53% of the assets of this country is owned by 1% of the population. So the rich have grown richer. The chota modis have run away. The Mehul buys have run away. And all these industrialists have become much richer. And the poor are not even having enough wherewithal to feed their family. That's the state of this country. And I'll give you another figure. About 70 to 80 crores. We have a population of 130 crores. 70 to 80 crores people in this country earn less than 10,000 rupees a month. And 70 to 80 crores means the population of Europe and America put together earn less than 10,000 rupees a month. That's the state of this country. During my time, we reduced poverty. 14 crore people came out of poverty during the UPA. 10-year period. 14 crore people came out of power. And all you have is a prime minister who only gives bhashan. Bhashan, shasan, bhashan se nahi chalta. Kaam kaaj se chalta hai.
So these are broad features in the farming sector and in the context of employment. But let me tell you some other very, very interesting features in this manifesto which have not been highlighted. Take, for example, education. As you know, we brought the right to education bill. Shiksha ka adhikar ka kanoon hum laye. Aur humne kaha ke class 1 se lekar aur class 8 tak shiksha ka adhikar hoga. सरकारी स्कूलों में कोई फीस देनी नहीं पड़ेगी और इसका नतीजा ये हुआ कि 100% से ज्यादा बच्चे हमारे अब स्कूल जाते हैं। हमने इसमें वादा किया है कि ये जो शिक्षा का अधिकार है ये एक पहली क्लास से 12वीं क्लास तक होगा। पूर्ण स्तर पे शिक्षा का अधिकार सारे स्कूल में सरकारी स्कूल में फ्री होगा। केंद्रीय विद्यालय और नवोदय विद्यालय हम बनाएंगे और साथ में हम संशोधन लाएंगे संविधान में कि एजुकेशन की जो एंट्री है जो आज के दिन कंकरेंट लिस्ट में है वो स्टेट लिस्ट में चली जाए ताकि जिम्मेदारी प्रदेशों की। वी हैव इन दिस मैनिफेस्टो सेड दैट व्हेन वी कम टू पावर वी विल इंश्योर द राइट ऑफ एजुकेशन विच इज टुडे लिमिटेड टू क्लासेस 1 to 8 दैट इज फ्री एंड कंपल्सरी एजुकेशन will be extended from classes 8 to class 12. So now we will have free and compulsory education from class 1 to class 12 when we come to power. And that education as an entry will be moved through an amendment of the constitution from the concurrent list, namely list 3, to list 2 of the constitution. We'll increase the number of Kendriya Vidyalayas, we'll also increase the number of Navodaya Vidyalayas. And of course, as far as teachers' training are concerned, we're going to make sure that there is enough institutions for teacher training programs for teaching our young people. And we are going to bring technology into learning in a big way. That's in the field of education. In the field of health, and also we have said that we will slowly increase the expenditure on education to 6% of GDP. Actually, the expenditure on education under the NDA government has gone down. It is less than 3% today. We promised to bring it to 6% of GDP. In the field of health, we have promised that we will bring health expenditure, the allocation to health, to 3% of GDP. And it is at the moment just about 1%, it's about 1.2%. That is samajik nyay. Jab tak hum apne bachchon ki shiksha pe upar dhyan nahi dete तब तक सामाजिक न्याय नहीं आएगा। स्वास्थ्य के ऊपर ध्यान नहीं देंगे तब तक सामाजिक न्याय नहीं आएगा। साथ साथ में हमने ये कहा है जो गरीब तबके के लोग हैं उनको हम ओपीडी डायग्नोस्टिक एंड ओपीडी और मेडिसिन फ्री मिलेंगे डायग्नोस्टिक और ओपीडी के लिए। इन अदर वर्ड्स वी विल गिव फ्री मेडिसिन टू दोज हु हैव टू गो थ्रू डायग्नोस्टिक्स for the purposes of finding out what ailment they are suffering from, and we will give them free OPD facility and no payment for medicine for those facilities. That's a commitment, and this will be in government hospitals, of course. And emphasis will be on primary health centers. That's what we have said as far as health is concerned. Not only that, we have said that we are going to have more doctors, nursing facilities and other things and programs of that nature. In women, that's very important. With women, we have promised that there will be 33% reservation of jobs in all central government posts when we come to power. 33% reservation. पहले तो हमने कहा है कि जो 33% रिजर्वेशन पार्लियामेंट में लाने जा रहे हैं वो संशोधन करके बाद संविधान का उसको पास करवाएंगे। विल अमेंड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड मेक श्योर दैट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट फॉर रिजर्वेशन ऑफ 33% सीट्स इन पार्लियामेंट इज पास। बट वी ऑल्सो हैव सेड दैट वी कमिट आवरसेल्व्स टू ब्रिंग अबाउट 33% रिजर्वेशन फॉर वुमेन इन ऑल सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट पोस्ट्स। That's a very important step. I'm telling you some broad things because I don't want to bore you with all the details. In the context of judiciary, again, The reform that we have talked about is to set up a constitutional court in Delhi. At the moment, the present Supreme Court is functioning as several Supreme Courts because they sit in benches of twos and threes. And sometimes one judgment is contrary to the other. And yet they speak for the Supreme Court. I think this should be avoided. We are committed to set up a constitutional court in India. And we will set up six regional courts with benches of with benches in six places of judges who in sitting in batches of two and three to decide matters. This is a huge reform. We are also thinking in terms of passing a judicial appointments commission, setting up a judicial appointments commission. In terms of the Judicial Appointments Commission, which will be a representative body not just of judges but also of members of parliament as well as members of society, which will include lawyers, to make sure that the right kind of appointments are made to the higher judiciary, and we will have a separate secretary. We're not happy with the present system. And thirdly, a Judicial Accountability Commission, where complaints can be dealt with in a bipartisan fashion. So, judiciary ke mein hum bahut bhari sanshodhan karne ja rahe hain. Humne faisla kiya hai ki hum constitutional court ka gathan karenge aur ye jo आज का ढांचा है ये नहीं रहेगा और कोर्ट सभी जजेस बैठेंगे और सभी जजेस इकट्ठा फैसला करेंगे इस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को और छह रीजनल कोर्ट्स बनाएंगे उसमें जजेस बैठेंगे दो या तीन की संख्या ताकि कन्याकुमारी से किसी को दिल्ली नहीं आना पड़े उड़ीसा से किसको दिल्ली नहीं आना पड़े दूर दराज से किसी को दिल्ली नहीं आना पड़े सुप्रीम कोर्ट को जाने के लिए वो कोर्ट ऑफ अपील हर रीजन में होगा ताकि लोगों को राहत खर्चा भी नहीं होगा और लोग अपनी जो दुख है उनको भी प्रकट कर सकते हैं करेंगे अपने रीजनल कोर्ट तो ये जुडिशरी के बारे में हमने एक बहुत भारी संशोधन करने का सोचा है फिर हमने कहा है कि एक राइट टू होम से एक घर का हक भी लोगों को मिले क्योंकि आज लोगों के पास घर ही नहीं उनके पास इतना पैसा ही नहीं है जो घर बना सके तो राइट टू होम से का भी हमने साथ साथ में कहा है और ये जो जीएसटी रेजिम है इससे भी बदलाव आने वाला है वी आर गोइंग टू इम्प्लीमेंट द जीएसटी 2.0 We're going to do away with the e-way bill. We're going to make the filing of returns very simple. Every quarter, only one form will have to be filed. Then, of course, at the end of the year, the return will have to be filed. We're also going to make sure that GST Council, the revenues that come to us, will be shared with the states as well. Then, we'll make जीरो रेटिंग ऑन एक्सपोर्ट्स ताकि एक्सपोर्ट्स को बढ़ावा मिले कोई इस पर टैक्स नहीं हो नेशनल सिक्योरिटी इश्यू में जो एनसीटीसी का हमने पहले ऐलान किया था जो इस सरकार ने लागू नहीं किया उसको हम लागू करें नेट ग्रिड वी सेट अप नेट ग्रिड व्हिच वी हैड डिसाइडेड टू डू बट दे डिड नॉट इंप्लीमेंट So the NCTC and NAT grid will be set up to ensure. And remember, all this was opposed to by our Prime Minister. He opposed the GST. If you remember when he was Chief Minister of Gujarat, he said that this is contrary to the federal structure of this country. Narendra Modi ne GST ka virodh kiya. Kaha tha ki sanghiya dhanche pe chot aayegi. Aaj उन्होंने जीएसटी लागू किया लेकिन गलत तरीके से लागू. एनसीटीसी का हमने गठन करना चाहा, एनसीटीसी को अपोज किया. ये भी संघीय ढांचे पे चोट पहुंचे. इट विल बी कॉन्ट्ररी टू द फेडरल स्ट्रक्चर द सेटिंग ऑफ द एनसीटीसी. सो ऑल एंड ही अपोज मंडे का यू रिमेंबर. In fact, made fun of us in parliament and then he embraced it. Not a single new constructive policy was taken forward by this government. New constructive policy. He copied all our schemes and tried to take them forward. But the two new constructive, the one new constructive policy which he called constructive was demonetization. And nothing was more destructive than that policy. As far as Dalits and Adivasis are concerned, the backlog of vacancies reserved for SC, STs and OBCs in government, semi-government and central public sector organizations will be filled within 12 months. And we will provide, we will pass a law to provide for reservation of SC, STs and OBCs in private higher educational institutions. And we will implement the Forest Rights Act in its true spirit. And as I said, we will give a right to housing and protection of arbitrary eviction and a slum upgradation and transformation scheme. So, arthik pragati or samajik jnan, economic progress and social justice, those are the pillars with which the nation can move forward. If you have any questions, I'll be very happy to answer. Sorry? Actually, this Prime Minister is, what should I say? He only talks of Pakistan, he's not talking about Hindustan. Abhi hamare Hindustan ke Pradhan Mantri hain, hamare Pradhan Mantri hain. Lagta hai ki unke nazariya keval Pakistan ki taraf jata hai. Pakistan, Pakistan, Pakistan. Aur bade apne logon ke bare mein baat to kijiye. Talk about your own people, what you are doing for them. If you wanted to have a surgical strike, you should have had a surgical strike on poverty. If you wanted a surgical strike, you should have had a surgical strike on unemployment. Those are the surgical strikes that this nation needed. Not in a sense becoming a pickpocket of those through demonetization who put their hard-earned money in their pockets. I mean, if I earn less than 10,000 rupees a month, that's not black money. That's not unaccounted money. And you froze it. Destroyed their lives. And I'm talking about 700 million people of this country. So what surgical strike? Surgical strike should be to empower our people. सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक करनी थी तो बेरोजगारी पे करते, सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक ही करती थी तो गरीबी पे करते. वहां तो आपको भक्ति नहीं है, भाषण देने के अलावा तो आपके कोई भक्ति नहीं है. आप 1,00,000 रुपया बुलेट ट्रेन में तो खर्च कर सकते हैं, 1,00,000 करोड़ रुपया बुलेट ट्रेन में तो खर्च कर सकते हैं, और 1,00,000 करोड़ रुपया आम आदमी की इलाज के लिए नहीं दे सकते. इनके देखिए इनकी प्रायोरिटीज क्या, व्हाट आर देयर प्रायोरिटीज. दे विल स्पेंड 1,00,000 करोड़ ऑन अ बुलेट ट्रेन बट दे विल नॉट हेल्प पुअर पीपल विद 1,00,000 करोड़. एंड व्हेन वी से दैट वी गेट 3.6 लाख करोड़ थ्रू दिस न्याय स्कीम, दे से वी विल गेट द मनी फ्रॉम, दे डोंट अंडरस्टैंड दैट द बजट ऑफ दिस, the total budget in this country is about 28 lakh crores.
Sir, some believe that until Pulwama happened, there was a level playing field. But post Pulwama, it became advantage BJP. Do you agree with that?
Some believe. So some do believe. The majority don't. You are right. Some believe.
Some.
Majority do not believe that. You are right.
Some in your party, some BJP people believe. Some in your party.
I don't know. You must be knowing more about my party than I do.
Your Manifesto promised the state,
Pondicherry. Yes, state will fix for Pondicherry.
All the inner territories are going to become states?
No. Pondicherry, that's in the Manifesto. Good state will for Pondicherry. No, not there. There is only Pondicherry. Printed work in RRT है। अच्छा मुझे तो नहीं मालूम। मेरा बता दो मुझे जरा मैं भी मुझे भी ज्ञान हो जाए।
आज की मीडिया में
हाँ तो आप जो मीडिया में लिखा जाता है और जो हम सुनते हैं कुछ चैनल्स में आप उसको मानते हो? कुछ मोदी मीडिया तो
for here. There seems to be certain sections of the vote base which is not liking the schemes. Especially, you think that certain vote base by the announcement?
I don't think so. I don't think so at all. Because we are not going to eliminate the other scheme, for example, the ICDS scheme. ICDS, food security. We're not eliminating that. Midday meals. We're not eliminating those schemes. I think that we have to have a surgical strike in such a way that there is a balance created within society that helps all segments of society. You know?
And especially this scheme, a lot of vote base, especially the upper caste vote base, are seeing it as a, you know, they have a lot of resentment towards this particular scheme.
Why should the upper caste have a resentment of this scheme? The upper caste has enough income to support themselves. These are people who don't have shelter, who don't have housing, who don't have enough food to eat.
Because they believe it's going from their pocket.
Everything goes from your and my pocket. Right? So the mother should be resentful that more money is spent on a weak child because it's going from the family's pocket. Is that the argument? Ek maa kitne bache hain? Theek hai na? Do to theek thaak hain, ek bimar rehta hai. और उस पर ज्यादा अस्पताल का खर्च होता है तो परिवार कहेगा कि नहीं नहीं ये तो हमारे पैसे से खर्च होता है. यही हुआ ना. ये दुख की बात है. अगर इस देश ये देश हम देशवासी हैं और हमारे हमारे देश में हमें देश से लगाव है तो हर जन को इंसाफ मिलना चाहिए, हर जन को न्याय मिलना चाहिए. एनीबॉडी You know, he's a true nationalist. Then he must accept the fact that every citizen of this country is entitled to justice. For example, we've also done another thing in this manifesto. We have said that all those people who are under trials for offenses for which the maximum sentence is 3 years, if they've been in under trial for 3 months and they are still in jail, they'll be released. We've also said that those who are under trials for a sentence, for a crime which the alleged sentence is 7 years, if they have been in jail for 6 months, they will be released. We need to have a soft human touch. I mean, you can pull out your AK-47 and do what you like. That's no way to deal with people. The AK-47 will maybe with words as well. You don't hurt people. The kind of dialogue that I see the Prime Minister indulging in is something that I've never seen in my life. Nobody has destroyed the status or diminished the status of the office of the Prime Minister as Narendra Modi. What kind of statements and what kind of dialogue? 1.8 crore cash is caught in the northwest from a convoy of a chief minister within the convoy. That's not corruption. Operation Lotus is not corruption. And he talks about the time when we eliminate corruption. You all know it's corruption will eliminate it. In fact, that is one of the three top concerns of the people of India. Employment, farmer stress, corruption. And look at pollution in this country. Out of 180 countries in the world, we are 176 in terms of air pollution. The real problems in this country are drinking water, air pollution, housing, food, prices, transportation. These are the real problems in this country. Has he talked about this? Pulwama, as you said, that's all that he talks about. And he says, I'm a chowkidar. And I assume he's a chowkidar. So when something like this happens, if I have a chowkidar in my house and somebody steals from my house, the first thing I'll ask the chowkidar, how did anybody steal from this house? Puchunga na, chowkidar se, ki bhaiya tu to yahan chowkidari kar raha tha. तो इतने एक्सप्लोसिव्स कैसे पहुंचे? आरटीएक्स कैसा पहुंचा? उस पॉइंट में कॉन्वॉय में तू तो चौकीदार था ना, आप तो चौकीदार थे ना, तो सवाल तो आपसे पूछना चाहिए कि चौकीदार साहब आप क्या कर रहे थे जब वहां आरटीएक्स पहुंचा? किसने खरीदा, कैसे खरीदा, कौन सी कार में आया, कैसे वहां लगा? आपने उस पर जांच की? हैव यू इवन अटेम्प्टेड टू इन्वेस्टिगेट दैट? What were you doing then? What happens is, then the chowkidar, if the chowkidar cannot explain how the house was laid, then there is a suspicion of the chowkidar. So, if we have this kind of chowkidar to this nation, say that, you know, God save this country.
So you mentioned
despite this chowkidar, what happened in Gurdaspur? What happened in Pathankot? What happened in Uri? What happened in Baramula? What happened in Pulwama? Why did the chowkidar allow Nirav Modi to go away or Choksi to go away? What is the chowkidar doing? And what is the chowkidar doing when our young girls are raped in Kathua? What is the chowkidar doing? Is this the kind of chowkidar that we want in this country?
You said you set up a society on Rafael when you come back to power.
We said we'll investigate Rafael.
So will you renegotiate the deal after a sponsor?
We said we'll investigate Rafael. That's what we said.
In this election, how many seats do you get?
What do you say? Give me some idea. Beyond the manifesto. Thank you.
Sir, one last question. Sir, the enforcement directorate has called for questioning of Rathore Puri, the nephew of CM Kamal Nath. And BJP is questioning that even the Kabarnath is also involved in the Agastha West.
They will question everything. Which leader have they not questioned except their own?
So what is your response?
Except their own leader, which leader have they not questioned? Because this is, you see, what has happened is we are not living in an age of Bodhi India. We are also living in an age of Bodhi Institute. The CBI is a Bodhi institution. The enforcement directorate is a Bodhi institution. The income tax is a Bodhi institution. We are living in that era. And for Amit Shah and the Prime Minister, the BJP is a Bodhi party. because the rest of the BJP have not said anything. It's a two-man engine which is now faltering.
Political vendetta, sir, against Ramallah? Sir, calling it a political vendetta against
Ramallah? I've already answered.
Sir, in the Unitex camp, it is alleged that Congress President Rahul Gandhi did a property transaction with Unitex, which was under the radar.
Again, the same thing. Just ask Prime Minister Ji, how was your name in the Binda Sahara diary with your name and the money mentioned against your name? And in Amritsar. What happened to that? What happened? Ask them what happened to the scam in Madhya Pradesh and in Chhattisgarh when those diaries were recovered. What happened in Vyapam? You see, when the scams which mentioned them, the diaries are mentioned, their names are mentioned, they are not investigated because you have good institutions who don't investigate. And then when the election comes, take for example, well, I'll answer one question on corruption. This was a promise. 2014, the whole thing was we'll bring a Lokpal, and UPA government fell on that account. Why did you not bring a Lokpal? Because you have no commitment to eradicate corruption. You bring a Lokpal at the end of your term because you know that as you brought it in the beginning of the term, I don't know where you would have been by now. This itself is dishonest. He can't be heard to be talking about corruption. Corruption behind closed doors, right, without an investigation, is still corruption. Thank you.
Sir,